Everybody, Julie from Artfully You, and today we're going to be painting some twisted tree roots. So I hope you find this video useful. Don't forget to tune in for part two next week. Let's go. So this is the sketch I did just with my Sharpie, and then this is the one I did on my iPad. And Leanne, you're asking about simplifying, so I'm hoping this will give you a little idea of how to kind of focus on literally seeing the wood for the trees. So I just kind of really simplified this down into shapes, because I want to do a more stylized approach, kind of more chunky and colorful and less realistic. I do want to do this a lot more stylized today. That's just my chosen style today. I really wanted to simplify the tree roots without losing the effect of the clinging onto the rocks. So I hope that kind of gives you a little idea of. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mute all the colors in the background and make this a lot more bold and intense in the foreground, so I have like a really distinct difference between the two. So look, this is what I did too. You can watch my video of how I did this. And this is the hand-drawn one I did as well. So I'll still do a paper and pencil one. So I'm gonna use my trusty Cerulean blue for my sky with a lot of white. And I'm gonna be using cadmium yellow and cerulean blue for my greeny backgrounds, but I'm gonna use ultramarine mixed with I'm gonna kind of add black and white just to gray this down. Or you could add raw umber, burnt umber to gray it down for my cave. So that's kind of the plan. So I'm gonna start with my cerulean blue along the top. Quite turquoisey, this one. I think I'm gonna add a little bit of ultramarine into my sky because this is coming out quite turquoisey. That's better. I just wanna make this a little bit bluer, and then I'm gonna add in my white. So, burnt umber and ultramarine blue makes a color that you can buy called Payne's Grey. So this is Payne's Grey. And it's not quite black. It's an alternative to black. It's a very blue-based gray, but you can make it with ultramarine blue and burnt umber. So it's the same color, if that makes sense. So you can see it's basically the same color. I just like to buy it in a tube because it's handier. But I'm actually gonna add some white to this to start with. So I'm gonna take my horizon line just below halfway out here. So there's kind of this little island coming out here with some trees on it. And then there's the cave a little bit higher up. So if you imagine this is my kind of island, which I can. I'll add some color to it later, but I just want to kind of get the shape here. This is my little island. And then my cave is more of the. Paint gray. That's a bit light, but I'm going to work it in. Now we can't really see from the picture because the foliage is in the way, so we're gonna have to just make a little bit of a guess for the background here. Well, the difference when you actually work with the thicker paint is like, oh, night and day. This is where I realize I've gone far too dark with my sky. So I think I have to lighten my sky before I go any further. Going to use a little bit of that raw umber in my little island here, and then a bit later I'm going to add some unbleached titanium for some highlights on that little island. The next thing I'm going to do is kind of a muted tree line above my island, and the colors I used for this is my cerulean blue for the sky, plus some yellow, cadmium yellow, lots of white, and then I'm actually adding some of that Payne's grey just to dull it down a little bit, just because I don't want this to be too vibrant. So I've often talked about tint, tone, and shade, and this is a tone. So this is adding grey to a colour to desaturate it, just to make it look a little bit further back. Going to use a very similar color for the water in front. So I've added a fair bit of yellow to this, and then I'm going to use the same cerulean blue and the Payne's grey just to kind of green it up a little bit. Don't really want this to look like grass, so I did play with this quite a bit while I was painting. So you'll notice that this I did fiddle with this quite a lot throughout the painting, but eventually I got the color that I wanted. Next thing I did was I added a little bit of sky reflection into my water using the cerulean blue, a little bit of Payne's grey, and some white. The next thing I did was add the rock face. So again, I'm using Payne's grey and some white. I did add a little bit of my cerulean blue,
just to blow it up a little bit, but it's mainly the paint grey. Again, you can make the paint grey with raw umber and cerulean blue or ultramarine blue and some white. But here I'm just sketching out the rock face. So this is actually an area in southern Ontario called Rockwood, because it's rocks and lots of woodland. I presume that's where they got the name from. But I'm fascinated by this place, the way that these tree roots just wrap around these rocks, almost defying nature by finding a foothold in what would otherwise be some land that you would think trees would not be able to grow from. So I just love the way these tree roots are just kind of finding a space to latch hold. So when I describe how to paint rocks, the easiest way to explain it is to think about your paint in a cube or a cuboid. One side is facing the light, one side is in partial shadow, and the other side is in full shadow. So if you think about a cube, then that's the easiest way for me to describe it. Again, using a combination of my color palette, so I'm just basically now using everything that I've used previously in other areas. So I am going to bring in some of my greens, some of my blues, my paint grey, my whites, just to get lots of different variations in the rocks. So the side of the rock facing the light, so my light source is actually coming from the left, the top left. So the side away from the light source will be a little bit darker, underneath will be very dark, and so the mid-tone will be on the right, darkest tone underneath, and the lightest part at the top, kind of left-hand side facing the light. So I painted in all the rocks first. Next week, in the part two video, we will be attaching the tree roots to these rocks. So what I like to do first is establish all of the rocks, build all of those rocks into the painting, and then I'll do the tree and the tree roots next week. So I'm going to speed this up a little bit so that you can always pause it in your own time. And yeah, I look forward to meeting you back here next week.